I at first wanted to congratulate Hills for Life. They raised $1 million in a short period of time. They were all new funds with their Hold the Line campaign, and wanted to thank everybody that was involved. It was everybody had a helping hand for the campaign. It was a full team effort. They reached out to the entire fan base. A lot of people on your websites stepped up and helped us, and I appreciate that so much, and want to say thank you, because everybody's got to be on board now for NIL. That's just it's a new thing, but it's real, it's here, and there will probably be changes over the next few years, but in this transition period, we've got to stay up, and we're working really, really hard to make sure that our NIL collective is as good or better than the others that are out there, and that's something that we got a little bit behind with, but really excited right now. So this is a step in the right direction. It sure doesn't mean we're there. We've got to continue to go. We said we need a minimum of $5 million this spring, and we're getting close to that, but we need to continue to work to get there. But again, thank you to everybody that contributed, and if you haven't, let's keep this momentum going and reach out to Hills for Life website and learn more and continue to give to the kids. Our guys have been great. We've had guys that people have tampered with, and that's a real problem across the country, but our guys overall have been great. They've been understanding. They basically said, Coach, you and the collective handle the NIL and we'll handle the football. So they're great young people, and I appreciate it. We've had a few staff changes. Corey Holiday, after 23 years, and he decided he wanted to spend more time with his younger son, who's a professional soccer player growing up here. And so Corey's retiring, and it's emotional for me when you have him as a great player and a captain and a leader, and then you come back and he's one of the top leaders in our building for our football program. So really, really proud for him. And we'll restructure the staff. And a lot of staff members will get added responsibilities, starting with Pat Suddes, because Pat does such a tremendous job for us. But we'll just make it work within the building and really just have other people doing a lot of different stuff. Daryl Moody retired. That's been in the works for about a year. Daryl wants to go play more golf and take some time off. And I think his brother's in Ashburn and has golf 3 days a week. And Daryl said, I'm missing that and I got to go do it. So, but Daryl's done a tremendous job for us with our guys, helping them transition to the NFL and giving them information. And then Sparky Woods wanted to pursue other opportunities because he's done a lot of great things here. But Sparky's a coach. He wants to coach and get on the field, and I totally understand that as well. So appreciate what those guys have done and how much hard work they've put in and how many lives they've changed over our last 5 years. Really excited about hiring Brian Simmons. He'll be the senior advisor to the head coach and our pro liaison. So he basically takes Coach Moody's place. And with that, what we will do is he'll also be involved in evaluation for the portal, because he's got such great experience. He was obviously, he's a legendary Tar Heel, first team All-American. He's in our Ring of Honor, first round draft pick, 10-year NFL veteran, and then 8 years experience as an NFL scout, and then 8 years experience as a high school coach. So he fits this role perfectly. He and Daryl are very good friends. They used to travel together with all of the scouting stuff. So it'll be a seamless transition. I'm actually speaking at a Nike clinic this weekend in Orlando, and Brian's going to pick me up and then take me back to the airport. And he'll be here in the first part of March and go through spring practice with the guys and make sure that he and Daryl work together with the combine and the pro day this year so our guys do not get behind. Our early enrollee class, we said we signed 30 that came in. That's 20 high school guys. Three preferred walk-ons, one junior college player that we said was eligible coming out of high school, and then six transfers. And those six transfers you'll get to talk to today. very proud of the group of high school guys that came in. Their average core GPA was a 3.448. So they're a very bright group. We've been on the road most of the time recruiting, but we just got back and getting to watch them for the last couple of days. They're very athletic, and it'll be fun to coach them this spring and should really help us have more depth in the fall, because when you're here in the spring, it gives you a chance to be more like a sophomore or at least a redshirted freshman by the time that the fall starts. But workouts are going really well. We moved spring practice back till the day after spring break, because we wanted more time in our off-season program. We've got some things we're changing and things we want to get done. So spring practice will start the 19th of March, with the spring game being at 3 o'clock on April 20th. So that will be afterwards. And that's the first time that we've done that, but all of our coaches are getting more involved in our off-season program, and we want another week to be able to do the things that we needed to do. You start 9-1 and you don't finish well. You start 6-0 and you don't finish like you want to. So we're close. We're so close. We got so many great things going, but we've got to uncover every little stone to figure out what we can do to change the narrative. So we're evaluating everything. And then you got to learn how to win close games when you don't play well. You're not going to play well all the time. And when you don't play well, when we've played well offensively, we usually win. If we didn't, we weren't good enough on defense, so we lost. What we've got to do is get better on defense, be more like we were 2 years ago in special teams, because we weren't as good this year. And then we've got to learn how, as coaches, to do a better job in tight ball games where we're not playing well and figure out how to way to win it. And that's the exciting part of where we are right now as we work toward that. We had a great recruiting weekend this weekend with the Duke basketball game. It's always special to bring guys in, and they had a great time. Before I turn it over to Pat, he's going to talk about each one of these guys individually like he did the high school signees. It's a little bit weird today's signing date. We're not signing anybody. So we were walking around today saying, isn't today signing date? I said, yeah, it's a little different than the old days for all of us. So it is different. Questions?
Just real quick on Corey Holiday, Mac. So you're not hiring someone for that role. You said you're going to delegate it, split it up a little bit.
Yes, we're just going to restructure. And the same thing with Sparky's position. We're just going to restructure and work within the building as much as we can to move things around.
How much will the Heels for Life, the money that you guys are raising, allow you to be really active post-spring practice in the portal?
It'll help us. We need to get another $1 million. We need to get to a minimum of $5 million. And then you've got to be able to have retention on your roster. I mean, that's really important now. We lost Diego. And then you've got to, and that'll be a factor at the end of spring practice, because then you start the next cycle of the transfer portal. And then I think it's even more expensive for guys in the second phase of the transfer portal, because guys that didn't get what they wanted to in the first part and go through spring practice and see how desperate they are to get somebody at that position. So we've got to be more competitive in those areas.
So you have to keep your guys in December, then you got to keep them again in April.
Absolutely. I laughed last year, and it's probably not very funny, but we had the spring game on the first day the portal was open, and at the pregame meal, I told the coaches, if you walk by a guy and he doesn't look you in the eye, he's probably out of here. So that's just what we've got. So it's that's the world we're living in. So I figured this out too. We can either gripe about it, or we can work it. And when we had COVID, it was really bad. It was an awful situation for our world. And as coaches, you could either gripe about COVID and the things we couldn't do, or you could be the one that was the most creative and innovative and make it work. Same thing with what we've got now with the transfer portal and NIL. One of the fun things for me is trying to make it work. We can all talk about all the bad things. There's a lot of great things with NIL. It's just that we read about all the horror stories, and that's what we got to get corrected. There's a lot of great things with the transfer portal. I go back to Joe Burrow. He would have gone down as a third-team quarterback at Ohio State instead of a Heisman Trophy national championship winner. So there's some great stories in the transfer portal. The sad stories are the ones that transfer four or five times, and every time something goes wrong, they're going to another place. So those are the things we've got to get worked out. We've got to work out what is best for NIL and the players. They're getting paid. They're going to get paid for the rest of their lives. How can we do a better job of making sure that we have a strategic plan where all of us can get involved with helping young people instead of having it all over the place? And well, I think that's one huge thing right now we've got to look at.
Will Brian continue his radio work on game days?
No, he's going to be working with us. So that was one thing that he had to consider. But he's so excited to get back. And like I said, I talked to him this morning. He's picking me up Saturday morning. And I've talked to him on the phone. I haven't seen him because we didn't need to interview him. So he didn't come in. He knows the place really well.
Mac, I want to go back to the balance between, you know, griping with the way things are now with the transfer portal and NIL and having fun with it, like you said, as far as being more innovative and all that. I mean, how do you handle that balance of being, you know, staying away from being frustrated to the point where, you know what, I've had enough, I'm fed up with this or whatever, and still staying focused on the fact that, you know, you have to keep up with the Joneses, with everybody else who is embracing this era of college football?
You know, you get up in the morning and we all need a purpose. And right now I have a purpose in helping our guys and helping North Carolina football. It's better than it was when we got here. Facilities are better. We're playing better, and we're so close. I want to get it where we wanted it, and that's. I think everybody got mad at me when I said 8-9 is pretty good around here. The truth is, it has been. That's who we've been on the good days, on the good years, and the truth is, that's not what we came back for, and that's not good enough. We want to win all the games, and it's so crazy next year with the 12-team playoff. I restructured our goals the other day, and I told our staff and our team, you want to win the opener, you want to win the ACC, and then you want to win your last game. And so your goals are different, and who knows what's going to happen with bowl games. And the other thing we need to do a better job of, if you're not in the playoff and you're in a bowl game, we need to do a better job of playing more people during the season and being able to manage opt-outs better. Because if not, you're just not going to win bowl games anymore. So we need to try to figure out who might opt out based on agents, based on NFL, and then play some more guys. So you just don't have one person that when they walk out, you lose the game. And that's just something we've got to look at. So it's challenging, but at the same time fun to take all this craziness. Easy to gripe, better to have fun with it and try to figure it out and try to help North Carolina get ahead.
Mac, in a perfect world, how many would you like to add in the next, when the next portal window opens? Or how many do you need to add?
We really are looking at a defensive lineman. That's what we need because we're thin with the younger defensive linemen. But other than that, we're in pretty good shape. And the other thing, Adam, that's where Pat's been so valuable. Roster management has become very difficult. Somebody may walk in today and say, I'm going in the portal, and then it changes your question. So going through spring practice, trying to be very honest with the players like we have, and then being in a position to, if these five guys are leaving, then you've got to replace them. And that's where the portal is so important at that point. And you've got to look at the portal every day. And in some cases, guys already know where they're going.
Right.
Yeah. So that's tougher with the tampering that's going on. But our staff does a tremendous job of looking at every one of them. I used to laugh. I used to send Pat every one of them. And all he would do, he used to call me and say, give me a long answer about, and now he just says, no grades. No character. Some chance. We're looking. I mean, but I've quit sending them to him because he's tired of answering my text. He's way ahead of me.
But O-line, you think you're okay at the offensive line now?
I feel good about where we are. Okay. There's a potentially we can be better in the offensive line next year than we were the last 2 years, in my opinion.
Okay.
I like what I'm seeing.
Can you elaborate on Howard and I'm Austin. I guess you cannot speak about the recent commitment, but.
Yes, Pat, I can't say anything about guys that aren't here, right?
I'm trying to trick you, Coach.
No. That's why I said you can't.
But you know, you're next, so they're going to get you.
So you can talk about the two that are here.
Yes.
You can't talk about the other one, that's fine.
Yes, so Austin.
What do you like about Howard and Austin?
Austin has been fantastic as a leader. He is fit in. He is a guy who can play all five spots because he has. I look out the window a few minutes ago, and before he comes in here to speak, he and Max Johnson are out there snapping the ball. But he has been so encouraging with the other guys to get them at everything. And I've seen him in the weight room. I've seen him run some. We can't see him with a ball. They just won't let us do that yet. But I'm really, really impressed with his attitude because he's been such a great leader in a short term. He was helping us recruit. But he was wanting to go everywhere and do everything. So I love his attitude. He's very similar to Corey Gaynor and what Corey brought us when he came in here with his energy and toughness from Miami. Howard's huge. You're going to see in a minute. He's huge, and he's got length. And we've really been impressed with him. And the good thing for him is so many of the young guys, I think Howard's got 3 years left, Pat.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Howard's got 3 years left, and the great thing for him is Randy Clements coached him, recruited him, and coached him, so he has been on the field with him and knows how good he can be, and we think he'll just get better and better and better. So, and then we can't talk about the other two.
All right, guys, we're looking to bring Pat in and let him talk about the rest of these guys.
Thank you all. Travel safe.
Appreciate you.
Thanks, Coach.
Philosophies out there with the portal, just like you see in the NFL. Some teams go heavy free agency in the NFL, trying to go all in to win a Super Bowl and then take a step back the next couple of years. I still think in order to sustain success, you still have to build it through high school recruiting, and that won't change here. But the portal has been good for us to add pieces, add depth, add experience to come in, and we kind of targeted these players and positions of areas that we needed to bring in guys with experience. And like Coach said, we'll be looking post-spring kind of what we need. The good thing is, though, having those 21 guys come in mid-year, we're going to get a great look at those guys to really say, hey, we thought we needed, you know, let's just say, for example, a linebacker, but those young guys coming in, I mean, we feel really good about them. So that's the benefit, again, of high school recruiting and getting guys to come in early. It gives you 21 extra guys to come in, which never really happened in the past. You might have 8 to 10 guys. 21 is very high, and we're excited about that. Starting on the defensive side of the ball first, Jakeen Harris, obviously that's an interesting transfer going from an in-state rival to here. But that's the nature of the portal now. And everybody's just looking for an opportunity to go and compete and play. The great thing about Jakeen, as soon as he hit the portal, he was able to drive over however many miles over here on campus, and we were able to visit with him. Just getting around him, he is a you can tell how important football is to him. He's tough as crap. Had the injury this year or would have played all year, but he's back full speed. He'll be ready to go. But he's got over 40 games of experience, 22 games starting. We need to bring a guy with experience, obviously losing Don and Gio to match with Stick and Will Hardy and those guys that are veterans back there. So for us, he's a ball hawk, very instinctive. You can see on tape, physical. And then the most important thing at that position is the tackling, because you're the last line of defense. Get the ball carrier down and live to play another down. So we're very excited about him, and he has been awesome since he's been here. He's got a great smile, engaging personality. I think he'll be one of the leaders on this team. And the team has really embraced him coming over, and he looks much better in Carolina blue than he did in red. going to offense, Coach kind of hit on Austin Blasky. I think for us, a couple things on Austin, why we liked, first of all, the tape is, you know, he's played tackle, he's played center. For us, you know, he'll go through spring, kind of figure out where he fits, but probably be on the interior, center, or guard. But he's just so smart and so versatile. He's a plug-and-play guy for us, and we're excited to get him. He has a lot of characteristics, traits of a Corey Gaynor, just because he's so tough, he's smart, When he came on his visit, he came to practice, and you can just tell guys that just love football, and he was just following the offensive line, taking notes, engaging with the offensive linemen, and he's already taken over, like Coach said, a leadership role here. He's always working out with the younger guys and developing those guys. So I think he's going to be a valuable piece for us, a la Corey Gaynor, who really it's more than just your talent and your playing ability, but it's how you bring those other guys, those five guys along. So him and Willie will be step up and be leaders for us on the O-line. Darwin Barlow, we were looking for a running back that had size. We were looking for a running back that had speed, and he fits both those, 6 foot, 220. He was a 10-7, 100-meter coming out of high school. With our new offense in the inside zone, just being able to hit it and go. So we really liked his tape. He's for a guy that's been out 4 or 5 years, doesn't have a lot of wear and tear on the body, which at the running back position is always huge. Guys that aren't banged up coming in. So we're really excited about him. He's got really, really good hands. So he's going to be a weapon for us out of the backfield in pass pro. Like, he's got the size to do that. But he's been great to have and really been gotten along with the players well since he's been here. Jake Johnson, obviously, we got the brothers, but they were really independent recruiting of the two. It wasn't just, hey, we're going to take these two guys as a package deal or anything like that. We were taking each one of them independent of their own. We think they're both great players. Jake Johnson has ideal length and size, 6'5 and a half, 240. He's got the athleticism and the pass catching ability that we look for in the tight end. Obviously, we've had a lot of success at the tight end position the last couple of years. We can bring back a lot of those guys, so he'll just add to that. He's actually got 3 years because there was an error on the A&M side where they listed 5 games, but we called him out on it, and they corrected it thanks to Jeremy. So he actually redshirted one of those years, so we have 3 years with him. But he's an NFL guy. He's a prototypical NFL guy. He's got great hands, natural ability. I remember looking at him when he was coming out of Georgia, and he was one of the top-ranked tight ends in the country. So we're excited, really, to have him. Obviously, when you talk about him and Max, just the bloodlines with Dad Brad playing in the league. Mom was an All-American volleyball player, and obviously the uncle is Coach Rick. So the bloodlines are good in the Johnson family. Getting to Max, we really wanted a guy that was a veteran. We wanted a guy that's played tough competition. We wanted a guy with some height, and we wanted a guy that's accurate, and then between the ears is a football savant, and that's what Max is. So we're extremely excited to get him, and the best part about getting Max, it's only going to make Connor better. And we still love Connor, and those two guys are going to battle it out going into the spring, but he's been awesome being here. Like Coach said, he's always on the field with those guys. Really embraced the leadership role and trying to bring guys along to go throw. He's extremely accurate. And then you can see he really does a great job standing in the pocket, taking hits. He's played against really good defenses, and he's done a really good job. He's played since he was a redshirt freshman at that quarterback position, and I think he's going to be he's going to really help us and really, again, push that quarterback room along. Howard Sampson, last one, obviously 6'8", 325. So when we're looking for a tackle in the portal, the first thing we look for is the size and length, because that beats anything. It beats you can have poor footwork, poor technique, but if you have the length to recover and play that position, that just sets you apart. So he's got that. Obviously, Randy recruited him when he was at North Texas, so we had a leg up there as far as the character piece, intelligence piece, all the background, which again is huge in the portal, because it's like drinking through a fire hose. You got 48 hours to really figure out if you want this guy, and then you got to get him on campus, and you got to battle these other teams. So for us, having Randy recruit him out of high school was huge. But he is, when you see him, he looks like he should be on the basketball team. But he does not look 325 either. He's got room to gain and get stronger, but he's going to be a valuable piece for us. And like Coach said, 3 years with a body type like that is huge for us. And those are the guys.
All right, Pat.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.